另外，在社区新闻方面，少数族裔媒体服务机构 EMS 近日召开网络研讨会，有请洛杉矶、迈阿密和凤凰城的首席热浪官分享经验。
随着极端高温天气对民众，特别是弱势和贫困群体的影响日益加剧，美国各城市和县政府近年来设立了首席热浪官和相似职位，负责提高公众对极端高温的认识，以及监督相应的市政措施。热浪已经成为了导致美国人死亡的首要天气相关因素，气候危机使得这些事件的威胁性不断增加。热带气候使迈阿密的温度更加危险，凤凰城是全国最热的大城市。专家预测，到2050年，洛杉矶将经历比现在多5倍的热浪。这三个城市的反热浪领导层分享了他们的经验和策略。
We need to work, as Marta so well articulated, across departments and even across community stakeholders to come up with this unified response, because it's not just one department that can solve this problem. You know, there's an emergency response role, there's a communications role, there's urban planning and tree planting, there's housing issues, there's a lot of different components.
几位城市热浪官也从各城市的独特角度阐述了政府应对热浪所采取的措施，包括针对洛杉矶预计的热浪增加，他们正在寻找有效的方法来提高城市的热浪抵御能力，以确保市民的安全。而凤凰城作为美国最热的大城市，其策略主要围绕如何降低城市热岛效应，并保护市民免受高温的伤害。
Climate action plans or local hazard mitigation plans or general plans. Well, now we're developing heat plans, right? Heat action plans, and we're calling ours the Heat Action and Resilience Plan. It'll be done this March. What's important to point out is that extreme heat wasn't seen as the primary climate hazard before I was part of this office, but now extreme heat is a huge part of every single one of those plans as a result.Of the work of this office and the advocacy of this office, which means we'll maximize our resources and maximize our investments to mitigate heat and climate change in the city of Los Angeles.
在会议的最后，专家表示，民众也应采取积极有效的措施，保护自己不被热浪侵袭，否则将有可能引发一系列严重的健康后果。凤凰卫视林汉琴洛杉矶报道。